It all started when I got drafted December 2nd, 1964. Boot camp at Fort Knox, Kentucky, then assigned to the 63rd Ordnance Battalion headquarters, Fort Lewis, Washington. Got orders in April 1965 that I was part of the advance party of 24 to go to Vietnam. The advance party consisted of high-ranking officers and sergeants and some E3s, and me, the only private. Out of San Francisco, we flew on Pan Am Flight 1, making several stops along the way. It was a very long flight, stopping in Honolulu, then Wake Island, then to Guam, and then Manila. From there, Saigon, Vietnam. The pilot made a swift descent to land, and the Air Force military police wasted no time escorting us off the plane while the remaining passengers said they would pray for us with well wishes and teary goodbyes from the passengers and the flight crew. We were in Vietnam. Stepping off the plane in Saigon, I became the first Army private in Vietnam. The next day, we were airlifted on an Air Force C-130 to Nha Trang, Vietnam. Nha Trang was a small town next to the South China Sea. We were the first Army. The Air Force, Navy, and Special Forces were there, and we were all considered as advisors. Nha Trang was an air base and headquarters for the Special Forces, also the Vietnamese Air Force and Vietnamese military. Automatically, I became private first class, and my new home was a tent with rats as large as small dogs running through our tents and flies sticking to you until you knock them off. Poverty like I had never seen before, with a smell that was disgusting. The Army served us K rations, and a P-38 became my best friend. So this is my story, not about dodging mortar rounds and bullets, but some of my unique experiences. The town in Nha Trang was more civilized, and the women started looking pretty good. They loved our money, and we were number one. My job was to run convoys between Nha Trang and Cam Rahn Bay, supplies to build a military base for sea and air. I was later reassigned to another battalion in Nha Trang and became a general's driver. Drove many generals from all branches, including the top general, General Westmoreland. Also the top general for the ROC Marines, General Lee. I spent a whole week with General Lee. He treated me as if I was his best friend. I drove him around in a 64 Ford the Air Force let me use, way better than a Jeep. We had several USO shows. Here's one of them. Mary Martin in Hello Dolly, featured on the cover of Life magazine, which I was on. Yep, that's me. Yeah, recognize my arm? Now here's my favorite passenger that I drove, Joey Heatherton. What? You don't know Joey Heatherton? Watch.
Yeah, we got a great show tonight. Orson Bean, Jack Gilford, the Mills Brothers, George Burns, and Joey Heatherton's back with us. She's beautiful, and what a built. Oh, She got the only body that Ralph Nader ain't called back yet. That's some kind of... She's a real decent kid. You know, she won't even curl up in bed with a sexy book. She's afraid it'll molest her. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the talented lady of whom I speak. I said that? Well, adjectives there. The lovely, adorable, wonderful Miss Joey Heatherton.
Let's take it nice and easy. It's gonna be so easy for us to fall in love. Hey baby, what's your hurry? Relax and don't you worry, we're gonna fall in love. We're on the road to romance, that's safe to say, but let's make all the stops along the way. Problem now, of course, is to simply hold your horses. To rush would be a crime. Well, nice and easy every time.
Sooner, but they had me in the back. They were throwing some cold water on me.
Really?
Yes, they were. That was some kind of number.
Thank you.
From New York, The Tonight Show, starring Johnny Carson. And now,
we're talking with Joey Heatherton, Jerry Van Dyke. You know, that would be something to dance to. Remember the old jitterbug? But nowadays they're not doing that anymore, right?
Right.
There are dances I haven't heard of. Am I square? I didn't think I was...
It.
What?
We're all out of it. We can't do the frug. None of us can do the frug.
The frug?
Yeah.
The slop?
The slop?
Yeah. Mashed potato.
The mashed potato was like a twist, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It's kind of like slop basic with the mashing potato.
Well, slop basic.
The frug, right?
Frug. What's the frug?
The frug is mostly,
Ham.
Ham.
I mean... Do some.
Dilly?
Well, the slob is usually,
What's the slob?
Our side of slob is a version.
Give me a slob.
Slob is...
I was just doing it. For me.
What is it? You know how it got started?
How did it all get started?
I figured it out. It got started. Play it again. This is from a guy that went. Play it again.
You have a feeling for this?
From a guy, the restroom doors were all locked.
That's how the limbo started.
Well, that limbo got started from a guy trying to save a dime in the pay thing.
What's the...
I'm cool.
What is the Watusi?
The Watusi.
Is there a Watusi in our dance? No, I'm not ready for that. Where do they do these things? Want some more of the Watusi? What's the idea of that?
Do a little about a 1939 jitterbug type of stuff. Like, No, that's too fast.
Huh?
No, but I'm not, that age anymore. Now, this is the way we use the jitterbug.
Square.
Ready? What do you mean, square? Ready? Go.
That was great in 1940. Well, I might have met you when I was 19. I'd be dead by now.
Now you know Joey Heatherton. Sometime in the 90s, I put together a video of some of my pictures, and this video is dedicated to those who made the ultimate sacrifice.
Mustang Sally, guess you better slow that Mustang down. Mustang. You've been running all over town.
touch this. Can't touch this. Can't touch this.